Oracle Planning Cloud provides access to the Groovy scripting language. Groovy allows you to create context-specific, dynamic business rules that can dramatically improve the performance of calculations and data movement in your application. Similar to business rules, you create Groovy rules in Calculation Manager. You launch Groovy rules from any place a business rule can be run. For a technical reference on designing Groovy rules, see the Java API reference for Oracle Enterprise Performance Management Cloud Groovy Rules on the Cloud Help Center. The Java API reference includes examples that demonstrate the syntax and power of the EPM Groovy object model. In this series of tutorials, you'll learn design best practices on how to use Groovy rules to perform focused data movement and smart calculations on planning data. In this tutorial, we'll show you how to best use Groovy templates to improve usability and calculation performance for user actions. By default, actions in Oracle Planning Cloud display a static list of prompt values to the user. In this example, the Add Hiring Requisition action for workforce planning displays only a list of static prompts. Launching the action calls the Add TBH business rule. You can use the template wizard designer to customize the user experience for actions. Note that you can design wizards with either Groovy or non-Groovy templates. Templates enable you to make your wizard choices conditional based on the user input. In this example, the Add Hiring Requisition action has been customized to open a wizard. The user's choice of salary option on the third page of the wizard determines what further options are available to select in the rest of the wizard. So when I select salary grade, the next page of the wizard lets me select a salary grade option. If I go back and select salary basis and rate, the next page of the wizard lets me enter a salary rate and select a salary basis. In addition to providing a more streamlined user experience, using Groovy templates for actions can also improve the performance of the calculation script generated by the action. Without using Groovy templates, the action generates a standard calculation, which needs to include conditional if-then statements to deal with the variety of user input choices. These conditional statements can be expensive in terms of calculation performance. The Groovy template can gather the contextual inputs from the form and dynamically generate a focused calculation script without conditional statements, providing overall faster performance when you launch the action. Let's get started. First, open Calculation Manager and create a template. I'll use a naming convention that indicates I'm going to use Groovy Script in the template, but you can name templates anything you like. In the New template, select the Edit Script view, then change the script type to Groovy Script and save the template. This is now a Groovy template. Next, you can create a custom step-by-step wizard. Note that the Template Wizard Designer is available for any type of template, not just Groovy. This tutorial does not cover creating wizards in detail. For more information, please see Designing with Calculation Manager for Oracle Enterprise Performance Management Cloud, available on the Enterprise Planning Cloud Help Center. To get started, go to the Design Time Prompt tab and add all of the items you want to prompt users for in the wizard. This is a complete list of the prompts I need for adding a requisition. Next, click Create Edit Wizard. In the Template Wizard Designer, you can define each step of the wizard and what prompts to show on each page. Notice that the prompts defined for the first step in the template correspond to the prompts shown in the user interface. Also, some of the wizard steps have an enabling condition that controls whether the step is displayed. For example, this step, where you can select a salary basis and enter the rate, is only enabled if the value selected for salary options on the previous page is equal to salary basis and rate. Once your template steps are defined, you can create your Groovy script. This script starts by defining variables based on the values collected in the Design Time Prompts, or DTPs. Oracle recommends using RTPS protocol to define variables. In this example, Process is the name of the DTP for salary options. This section also defines a map for time periods. Then the script validates the prompt values. An advantage of Groovy Script is that you can add validation checks that run prior to calculating anything on the server to make sure the entered prompt values are valid. In this section, the script checks to make sure that the hiring start date is not later than the hiring end date. You can have up to 100 hiring requisitions. In the next section, the script creates a data grid to store and increment the number of the current hiring requisition. The exception catching code at the end finds errors while building or loading the grid. The next section of the script uses a switch case to pass the DTPs to predefined calculation script templates. These sub-templates generate the actual calculation scripts. Each case statement passes different DTPs to the calculation templates. In the calculation templates, you can see places where conditions are required. Here, for example, you need different code depending on which salary option is selected. Without a Groovy template, these conditions must be processed during the calculation using expensive if statements. But with the switch case section in this Groovy script, the script sends predefined, specific DTPs, and only the relevant code is generated. For example, in case 2, the DTP is salary rate is assigned a value for the compensation template. This satisfies the first condition in the compensation template, is salary rate equals equals is not empty, and therefore generates only the assign basis and rate code block. The Groovy script includes switch case statements for each conditional branching in the calculation templates, which ultimately creates a custom calculation script that's based on the selected prompt values. When your Groovy template is complete, deploy it. Finally, modify your actions menu to launch your Groovy template. I'll select the Groovy template. Note that in this example, the artifact label has been changed to provide a more user-friendly name. Now the actions menu item for Add Hiring Requisition will use the Groovy template. In this tutorial, you explored best practices on using Groovy templates. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.